I've always preferred not to have super bright lights right in my eyes if I'm trying to relax or just chill. So I'm going to be putting some strip lights around the top edge all the way around, and came up with a little bit of a different way of doing this. Let's pretend that this is the wall and this is the ceiling. Or I'll rotate it so it's a little bit easier to understand. There you go. I went up to the table saw and cut up a whole bunch of sticks in this specific profile. That's up against the top edge of the wall and ceiling. And then I have just standard crown molding, which I'm going to install this way, just like that. That creates a little pocket at the top. In that pocket, I'm going to put some LED lighting just set right on the top. That way, the light is going to be bouncing off the ceiling. You can see that this piece is going to be exposed when the crown molding gets put in. So this needs to be white. Molly is going to go all the way around the entire top, caulk it and paint it before I put up the crown. That way we don't have to try to get in there with a tiny little paintbrush and get that face, that front face. Just like that. I think that looks pretty good. I went ahead and put a little section of some other LED lights that I had laying around up in there just to make sure that it worked. And I think it looks pretty good, especially at night. Unfortunately, earlier that day, I was pretending to be a mechanic working on my son's truck. Even though I had washed my hands really well, I still managed to touch the ceiling. And yeah, I'm gonna have to repaint a little section of the ceiling. Shh, don't tell Molly. Molly and I have been going back and forth quite a bit ever since we started this project on how to finish out the posts. We were going to, some of the ideas would be to actually clad it with wood. A bunch of different options, metal, those sleeves that go over and whatever. So I think we're actually just going to leave them raw. I'm going to router the edge over, which I'll show you that in just a second. But I want to say a quick word about the fact that yes, this is treated wood. There's a lot of people who still think that you cannot have treated wood inside a house. That used to be the case because it was had formaldehyde in it. Quite a few years ago, they changed the formula and they're now treated with copper, not formaldehyde. You still don't want to eat it, but it's no problem whatsoever having it inside the house. And probably going to paint them or something anyway. So I'm just going to use a little roundover bit and go all the way up as far as I can to the top. And then we'll have a piece of trim that goes across the top and also the bottom to cover the brackets that are holding it to the concrete. Holy mackerel, that sun is hot. Next up is going to be putting up the curtain rods. Wow, got all dusty. I'm going to get some help so I don't drop something and get these installed. I'm using these ridiculously large screws. I don't know what kind of weird oxide coating there is on them, but I went ahead and painted the heads black so they match the brackets. And the last thing on this stage is getting the little bits of trim at the top of the poles. I am just going to use some base molding and some quarter round for that. I think that looks good. Got the rod up, got the last of the trim. Really the only thing left in this room is the floor. Molly's getting the last little bits of caulking and painting done. And that'll be it. Okay, bye.